so many areas to go when we're talking about helping the homeless. And it's amazing that around Thanksgiving and Christmas, there's such an outpouring. And even the food bank, it's in abundance during that time. But around this time of year, there's hardly nothing in there. And we depend on the food bank tremendously to help us with our ministry. And from this time until Thanksgiving, it's almost barren in there. And people are coming from all parts of Oakland, men, women, children, senior citizens, veterans, you know, to the food bank because they're in need. And coming to the food pantry where we work at to serve breakfast. And it's just, you know, the need is just great. And one thing that I had to teach and show the guys that work there is like, don't look at the things that are coming at you, because it's a lot of, you know, tension sometimes. Don't look at the people straight in, you know, if somebody's in your face, if something looks strange, if something looks different, you know, don't be willing to turn away from it or fight it or, you know, beat it down, you know. Take a step back, I tell them, from the situation. To take a step to the side of the situation and look around and say, what's behind this? What is the cause of this? Mm-hmm. What is the reason these things are happening? What is the reason these things are coming at me or being presented in my face like this? You know, it's clear in Ephesians, it says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, the powers and principalities yes. of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. I don't know what to tell you. All I know is that these are sons and these are daughters
yes, yes, yes.
of someone.
Yes.
And not only that, I've been sitting on the street corner drunk because of pain from my past. You know, sometimes the pain from your childhood and your past doesn't even manifest until you're 20, 30 years old. And you don't even know the confusion and the torment and the things that are going on and why you can't hold the job down and why you can't stop drinking and why? Yeah. You know, I'm lost out here. I can't figure it out. I can't even get my own head straight because of pain that's happened in the past that has not been dealt with, that all of a sudden just comes up and just manifests itself in alcoholism and drug abuse and mental issues and all kinds of situations and the things that have happened. I mean, from the times of slavery, you know, the anger and the hatred and the all these things that block, you know, us from helping one another, because you know. That guy looks like the guy that I've seen on that movie with the Ku Klux Klan, and he looks just like him. And I associate everybody that looks like him as evil. So I can't even talk to that person. I don't even want to touch that person. And the dirt and the smell and the stench of evil, of Satan, of hell, of sulfur, of all those things, well, that's what we're supposed to be in battle against. Mm-hmm. We are supposed to be those warriors that stand up against the evil that is coming down. And it's coming.
Yeah.
It's coming.
Yeah.
It's coming.
Yeah.
Full force. Yeah. Full force.
Mm-hmm.
Full force. There are powers and principalities over this area that we were in a prayer group. And we were coming in, we were listening to pray against them, and somebody in the prayer group said, Lord says, you're not ready yet to even pray against those powers and principalities that are over this area.
Yeah.
You're not even ready. Because those need to be dealt with fasting and prayer.
Yeah.
And you're not even ready to pray against those powers and principalities that are there. So we need help from each and every one.
Amen.
And it starts first in your own prayer closet, in your own prayer time, to figure out what it is God has truly called you to do.
Yeah.
What are your talents? What are your gifts? Because all our talents and our gifts are to be used to bring people into the kingdom.
That's right.
Into the kingdom. And all of those things are embraced with love. And if there's no love, there's no power. There's no nothing.
That's right.
It's just a bunch of, you know, wasting your time. We need grant writers. We need money. We need all kinds of things. But if there's no love, because some of those people argued. A lady came into the program one day, and she just kind of stood there and looked at me. And then she said, would it be possible if you could just hug me? And I reached over and I hugged her. And believe me, it wasn't the easiest thing to do. If you were to look at her and to smell her and to just, you know, all the breakout on her. And just like,
I don't want to get in.
Yeah. But then the love said no. And the love embraced and held her as she wept in my arms and literally just lost all, you know, I had to hold her up. She said, nobody has touched me in 5 years. Wow. That's home. That's the reach. That's the outreach. We serve food. We serve the Lord, and we serve love. And we try to put love in everything that we do.
Amen.
And that's all it's all it's about. It's just reaching out and loving them.
Amen.
Amen.